Nestus, but if we have three people who have mega heals, why not?
You know what? I like it. I like it. I like the crazy draft coming in from EVO's SG, taking the XP laner Alice. I wonder who they got that from. Their brothers from Indonesia, Anti-Mage. All right. Well, with Gear coming in as the Alice in the XP lane, you can really expect him to just not do anything in the early phase. Yep. He just wants to scale.
It's all about the timing, right? And with the Glorious Pathway, it kind of enables them to just run through the team fights and maybe peel through where the Estus is. And of course, AoE damage, well, you can also expect AoE damage, I mean, from the Alice. What I'm really, really scared about for the side of EVO's SG is that will they be able to actually get into the back lines? I mean, you can say that because of this Hylos, they will have access, but there's still Estus, so... If they don't have anti-heal, I think they will not be able to just get into the back lines.
Well, absolutely. But ladies and gentlemen, we are into game one right here as we enter the Land of Dawn. Again, game one of a best of five series amongst the last two MPL champions.
Hylos jungle.
Yeah, it called it. Hey, bit of Todak of colors in there.
Hey.
But honestly, I think this is going to be a really interesting setup because now the mega carries from the side of EVO's SG is going to be both Gear and as well as Adamir. And they're going to have to really step up in this game because the entire team is designed to support around them.
Right, but Potato will be able to collect that little wanderer. Edward has actually made a rotation here towards that little wanderer. But again, EVO's SG, they pick up the first neutral objective, I guess you could say, as Haji just keeps on going into that mid lane, trying his best to get that level 2, but zoned away instantly by Ceylon.
I want to say, though, EVO's SG, they revealed in the interview that they are prepared against Blacklist International. And if you just judge the speed of when they drafted, actually, especially with their pickups, they don't take as much time. It kind of tells me that they may have expected Blacklist International to go for their picks, and they have prepared accordingly. Hopefully, their homework will save them this time. But EVO's SG, let's see how they approach this. I really don't like this Alice in the XP lane, unless it's Anti-Mage.
Hey, what do you have against Gear, man?
Yeah, man.
I've seen it before. I mean, other teams aren't that good with this XP lane Alice, but we'll see. I hope I am wrong.
Oh, Potato gets a stun on Haji right now. No follow-up just yet. He's going to be able to Shunpu over the turtle wall right there, as it is going to be 3 seconds left until the first turtle spawns. It should be Blacklist International with the pressure. Stun comes in once again. Wise is going to be able to get out of that one.
Yeah, it's interesting to see how they're playing this. They're utilizing a Potato. He's going to be roaming through the mid lane most of the time, taking the most aggressive path to kind of start opening up the map with his two supports by his side. Generally, there's nothing to be worried about. However, Haji, you know what he's like. You know how he wants to play this. If he gets a good kick on towards Matilda's side, hopefully there's going to be a Bloom coming in from JPL to maybe save his life. But even then, it's hard to say. He does only have a concussive blast.
All right, but right now, let's take a deep dive at the items here. Sure, no kills on the board, but it is actually going to be Gear jumping in with the Flowing Blood, and also the Eagle all the way to the backside. Wise is going to be targeted, but look at the damage they have put onto Edward. They're going to keep on going in. It's going to be Gear missing it out. Haji goes over the way, the Dragon all the way. Potato going to get kicked back to his team. But now, look, it's going to be an all-out fight, and Evo says, he's not going to win this. Gear going back, and that's going to be first blood picked up by the hometown boys. Wise trying to get a pickoff, trying to get a trade. It is not going to work out right now, as JPL still able to live. But it's going to be Gear going in once again. 3v1 goes out with Flowing Blood. Edward able to catch him with the death as well, but it's not going to be connecting onto a wall, as that is a 1v1. Blacklist getting the lead, but it was off of a turtle. But man, EVO's SG looking to fight early on.
Yeah, I kind of like it. I mean, it's so interesting how these compositions are kind of playing around each other. Very clear ideas of what they want to do. And I think even Blacklist International are starting to understand, okay, wait, we got to think about this for a second. Gear really does want to get into these early interactions. He's a lot harder to kill with the help of Sayla and as well as JPL.
You see that EVO's SG actually used this revitalize on this Matilda. Really, both JPL and Sayla, despite having a position for a mid laner as well as a roam, will always focus on just supporting EVO's the other members of EVO's SG. So it is indeed going to be like a 4-protect-1 strategy, or maybe a 3-protect-2 strategy for EVO's SG. This trio from the Matilda, this Florin as well as this Hylos will just look to sustain and look for the damage from both the Brody and the Alice.
Don't you think it's a little crazy here?
It
Wait,
is.
Hold on, hold on. I'll get to it in a little bit, but Gear is trying to get on out. But yeah, Yeah. Isn't it crazy that when you see Estus, it takes two revitalizers, two supports, and an Alice to out-sustain him?
Oh, wait a minute. Potato is going to go in right now. JPL is tanking the turret, but it's not going to be working. It's going to be Phoenix actually out-sustaining the damage. And Adamir, he does not have the turret upon memory. Potato, he might have just went over-aggressive. Haji going to be able to kick him back to the team. Potato is going to be taken down. Haji picks it up. And Blacklist with a 3-1 scoreboard on the first game.
What a weird decision from EVO's SG. At the same time, Blacklist International just cleared the minion wave so that they can deal the damage against a dive of EVO's SG. And that dive, again, the outer turret energy shields in the gold lane provide 25% damage reduction, and you saw how tanky the members of Blacklist International looked behind the turret.
Yeah, that was definitely not a good dive, considering that, again, damage reduction, healing from Estes, and the Clint that still has the flicker up, you know? I don't think that would have worked there, but all right, it's going to be punished. 2,600. You can see how Blacklist just chains those little, just few kills on the board to a huge gold lead.
They're starting things off very, very well, and we're looking at the first items here. Wise already has his Hunter's Strike. Edward, most importantly, does have the Sky Guardian's Helm, so he's going to be stuck in lane pretty much forever until his mana runs out, which even then, it's probably not.
All right, let's see. Blacklist International already trying to invade the enemy jungle. EVO's SG don't have a way to take it. It's gonna be Potato actually picking it up. Now Edward going for the Deathless Welcome onto the backside. We'll be able to catch onto Potato right now as he's gonna be stunned up, but it's gonna be EVO's SG still out-sustaining. JPL gets taken very low, but it's gonna be the engage. Wise actually taken very low. Torn up on memory finishes off with Dragon onto Adam, but it's still in it. Gear in a 1v3 right now. It's gonna be a crazy fight as everyone is just 1v1ing. JPL is gonna get taken down. Gear almost takes Edward down. It's gonna be Ohan picking up another double kill. Adam jumps in. But the healing from the queen! Blacklist will be able to win it out in the end. A 3-for-1 trade on the board.
What a trap recoil coming out of Ohep, predicting that the flicker is going to come out, and they bother to hold their ground despite being so very low. Holy, look, we got to see these micro plays once again. It's not even about the macros, it's just the overall raw mechanics from both sides. Yeah. Just look at how sustainable EVOS's composition is, and Blacklist pull away from the regeneration. It looks all good. Gear gets his, he will eventually get this kill on towards the bottom side. But then, this is where you see something absolutely crazy. Boom! That's when Ohep manages to catch him with the recoil trap, and that is more than enough to turn that tide.
The fight really was so long, but it was SG. Unfortunately, they run out of steam. But if you're looking at Oh My Venus, he's got an almost unlimited amount of heals because that he's just dependent on the skill. For Evo's SG, they need the revitalize. They need two revitalize, for both JPL as well as Sayla. So Evo's SG, if the fight is longer, that fight is extremely long, they will not be favored. Unless, of course, they get the jump onto Oh My Venus first. But it seems like Oh My Venus is being protected by the rest of Blacklist International.
What we do need to take a look at EVO's SG's draft is that they're kind of a late game composition here. They can't really go for those early fights, I feel like, right? You're going up against a Clint, against a Cho. This is not going to work out. And there you go. Haji going in very aggressively onto Potato. Not going to be able to get away with the Dragon as Potato takes a lot of HP. But Adamir, he's going to get caught out. Deathless Welcome connecting, and he's going to be put onto the team. But look at an engage coming in from EVO's SG. They're going to go in. Oh my god! The AoE burst from the snipers from Blacklist. A wipe out in the 8th minute of the game. Blacklist are ferocious. EVO's SG, they bit too much than they can chew.
That was insane coming out of Wise. I'm not gonna lie, his super positions hitting more targets than you would have expected, and he basically didn't need to change positions with his entropy at all. His disruption was more than enough to buy that time for Ohep to clean up the rest.
7 minutes, you know what to expect. It's the ultimate bonding experience, and Blacklist International grouped up. The real MVP, at least for me, is Edward with this dominant size as well as the Sky Guardian helmet, just tanking through, making sure that he's in front of EVO's SG. And when EVO's SG just tried to attack Edward, he just tanked it all out, and then eventually pops the Daytona's Welcome. EVO's SG was left in a checkmate, and after they got killed one after the other, Blacklist International just destroyed EVO's SG.
All right, at this point, you just need to ban the guns on Oheb's heroes, all right? He can't play anyone with guns. Edward going in for the death as well. Will be able to connect on the potato, and there is nothing he can do. He's going to get taken down. Wise picks up a mega kill, and the gold lead turns to 10 before the 10th minute. This is insane. The fact that they're always just fighting and coming out on top, 13-2. So much action on the board. You would expect Evo's SG would be able to get some more kills on the board, but no, it's just all blacklist right now.
Oh, at this point, you don't have damage from Evo's SG.
That was so fast.
Because of two marksmen available for Blacklist International, turrets as well as neutral objectives, they're gonna melt. And now, at this point, Edward already has his third item, a third defensive item added. As Evo's SG, we're talking about how they're lacking in damage. Well, guess what? The Radiant Armor just makes it so difficult now for Evo's SG's magic-based composition to be able to pierce through the armor of Edward.
Well, that's not all. I mean, Blacklist International, look at Oheb. He's already got three items already built. He has more gold than Y, shockingly enough. And I think this just might be checkmate for Blacklist International.
Oh my god. That was a brilliant kick. But Edward going in for more right now. Potato is going to be spat out onto the wall. A lot of damage has been placed. He's going to get bursted down, melted even. As Y jumps in, it's going to be everyone taken down. Unstoppable picked up. They're just racking in kills. As Evos, they can't do anything. Gear goes in for a 1v5 in a desperate attempt to save the game. But Blacklist, as dominant as ever, will take game one.
The experiment did not pull through. And unfortunately for Evo's SG, they went in for a different kind of draft, as they said in an interview. And the Blacklist International just tore through it. The Estus from this Filipino squad is still unbeatable. Absolutely.